So I'm sitting here stuck in this deadlocked traffic, and I realized while working on these videos for the truck disc brake conversion, where we've left off, it's all from last year, and from where we've left off now is when I got arrested for wrongfully arrested, gone through my court and everything. So they arrested me on my own property, like idiots, and so I didn't film what I ended up doing for getting those shaft collars on. So what I ended up doing was just setting them on the top. I had a wood-burning stove behind the sheds there at the shop, and so I just set them on top of that, and I just hit them with the propane torch and heated them up, and then just carried them over with my welding gloves and popped them right on, because they expanded and they went right on, snug fit. So I realized while going through the footage and everything that I didn't film that part and I didn't discuss that part. So there's that, and now here's the rest of where I'm at with my truck project. And I think where this video leaves off is where I'm still at here in 2021. It's October of 2021 now, and I'm pretty sure this is where I've left off on the truck project so far. Anyway, so this is what I still have other stuff to get done, but here's where I'm at. All right, so this is a truck video. I've never went back to working on the van after I found out my friend died and then COVID took off. It is July. I know I've been asked about the coronet. It's over there. It's just waiting. But yeah. So what I've been doing is working on my truck again. It has been going through the 4.3 conversion. I started that in 2016. And now I'm putting disc brakes on it because that's kind of necessary. So I'm going to try and see if I can pause the video, flip the camera around, and start narrating all of that jazz. Alright, so there's most of the stuff that's not on the vehicle yet. I got the master cylinder booster kit supposed to go in the original mounting location. We'll see. That's for... Sorry, I'm tired. Excuse me. That is for the reservoir for the brakes. I got that. That's calipers. That's the proportioning valve. This is actually new shackles. I'm gonna replace these worn out, beat up, tweaked out shackles. So, yeah. Got brand new tires going on. So far, so good with the disc brake conversion. I need to heat up the bearing adapters for the rear bearings so that they'll expand and I can slide them on. Those are just the old ones sitting there so I can move the truck. And then I can get that done. I can put the brakes on, and I'm working on the master cylinder also, like I showed you. And that is located, still the old single reservoir, but I have a 700 R4 and a 4.3 V6 in it now, so definitely need the disc brakes and dual master cylinder. So it is the 3rd of July, Friday, 4th of July weekend. I'm gonna see if I can get this going down. Rocking. Got the shackles replaced. Finally, after however many years. And then the master cylinder is in place. But I still have to get rid of the peg. It was stuck. I just ended up cutting it. Come on.
disc brake.
So I started this engine swap in 2016, very early, like January 2016. So it got put on the back burner. Then my mechanic had my truck for 14 months for an 8-hour job. And I'm finishing up some of the stuff that I asked him to do and the other stuff that I was going to do after I got it back from him because, yeah, whatever. Fuck him. It's looking fucking sharp. I love those new shackles. Can't wait.